So in this video, I'm going to show you a little bit about the Harmon mute. And here it is. This Harmon mute that I have is called a bubble Harmon mute. It's made by Jo-Ral. The bubble mute, to me anyway, has a richer, warmer, darker tone that I really like. The Harmon mute has a stem. Here's the stem. And you can either play it without the stem, as Miles Davis often did, and many players do, or with the stem. And I'll start out with the stem because it's kind of an interesting sound. With the stem, it's sometimes called a wah-wah mute. And the history of this mute is a little obscure, but it's believed that the initial idea for this was come up with by Joe Oliver, King Oliver, who was Louis Armstrong's mentor. And when he moved to Chicago in the early 1900s, he had this idea for this mute, and he mistakenly told this guy by the last name of Harmon about the idea, and this guy ran with it and never gave Joe Oliver any credit. Scotty Barnhart, the soloist for the Count Basie Orchestra, is the guy where I read about this story. But anyway, this is the Harmon mute, for good or ill. And first, I'm going to start with the stem in, so it's called a wah-wah mute. Now, when you put any mute in, you don't want it to fall out, of course, and do the accidental mute solo. So when you put your mute in, you're going to breathe a little breath in your bell, like that, to get a little condensation built up, and that will allow the mute to stick a little better. You can see there's some cork here, and so when I breathe in here, I'm going to push the mute in, give it a little twist, just like you do with the mouthpiece, and there you have it. Now you can see that this mute has some dings in it. It's seen a bit of use. Ideally, you want no dings at all. A really bad ding will actually affect the intonation. Now, one thing about the Harmon mute is that it will cause your pitch to rise quite a bit. It will make your trumpet play very sharp. So it's really important when you first get a Harmon mute to play with a tuner and find out exactly where in tune is with this mute. Now, for me, I know where that is, so I'm going to go ahead and pull out my slide to the right spot. And right about there. I'm going to do just a brief tune for you, not even the whole thing. This is a tune by Dizzy Gillespie, whose real name is John Birks Gillespie, and the tune is called Birk's Works. And I'm going to use the wah-wah function of this mute, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold the horn in my right hand, and I'm going to reach up with my left hand and do this kind of motion with the stem, and you'll hear what it sounds like. So let me move my mic here. And again, this is called Birk's Works. So there you have the mute with the stem. So now I'm going to take the stem out and do just a brief excerpt from a Miles Davis tune called All Blues, which is a very, very famous tune, one of his best known tunes. And you'll hear that the sound quality is very, very different. And here it is. And you'll notice when you play with one of these mutes that there's a lot of back pressure. There's a lot of pressure, so it's really difficult to push your air through. In order to sound loud on this instrument, you have to really blow. And that usually makes your face turn red and your veins pop out and all kinds of fun stuff. But anyway, here is just the first few bars of a tune called All Blues by Miles Davis, playing with the Harmon mute and no stem. So here you go. Thank you. So there you go. That's the Harmon mute. Check it out. They're really a fun mute. It's my favorite mute, and they're a lot of fun to play. People really like the sound. So check it out. Get yourself one. They're not cheap, but they're a lot of fun. Good luck.